Okay, so this is fine, but this isn't a very good use of jQuery. As I said, we can always just go in and edit the HTML or CSS. jQuery is much more interesting when it's used either conditionally, that is, if something happens, then change something on the page, or based on an event. So the most common event is click. So what we can do is we can get rid of this text for now. We'll leave it. We'll hide it over here. I'll cut it. And we will do click. So what this says is select the H1, and when that H1 is clicked, do the following. So we say do the following by saying function, boom, boom, open curly brackets, and then down here somewhere we close the curly brackets, close the parens, and do a semicolon. This structure here, remember, is just like this one. Do everything in here. So what this means is we want to put all the things that we want to happen when H1 gets clicked right in here. Okay. So what do we want to do? Well, let's again say what do we want to do it to. So we have to select something again, and we're going to select this, which is a funny thing to select, but it means whatever it is I just clicked on. So it's kind of this is whatever it is we've been dealing with to get here. Select it, and then let's change it to. Then we can post that back in. Then we'll change the text. So we're going to save that. Again, what this is click when it gets clicked on, change this to hello world. Let's see. Well, we have to refresh this. Hey, it looks just like it did before. Great. But now when I click on it, it changes those things to hello world. Again, I can't imagine why you'd want to do that in a web page, but you get the idea. By clicking on it, you've changed something. You didn't have to change this. We could actually instead change all of the, say, paragraph tags to hello world when you click on the this, but that's a little strange. So it changed that one when I clicked on that. All right, so but let's stick with this for now. So it changes this to hello world. We instead of having it change the text, we could actually append it, that is add to the text. Let's just say we really want to be emphatic. So we're going to append an exclamation point whenever someone clicks on it. So we'll say, we'll refresh this and we'll click on it and it gets a little exclamation point and we can keep appending, ad infinitum, say hi, 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 hi. And you can see that as we click it, it adds an exclamation point, so we could append to it. We could add a class, and let's add a class called Red. I don't think we have a class called Red, so we'll have to go over here and add in a class in CSS Red, and it should be obvious what this does. It changes the color to red. And then we'll close that, and also we'll save that, and this is already saved, and we refresh this. Now when we click on it, it will add the class Red, so let me refresh that real quick. So let's look in Firebug. Let's select that, the H1 here. You'll see it's got, here's the header H1. Now when we click on it, it actually adds in a class right here. It just bumped that Red in there, which is pretty cool. Of course, we can't get rid of it, so maybe what we'd want to do instead is toggle class. And then if we toggle the class, when we click it one time, it turns red. When we click it again, it takes it right back out. So it adds it in, takes it out. Pretty cool. We could do something even more fun. We could do fade out. Let's do that. I think that's the right format. Let's try it. This is kind of one of the things that jQuery is famous for, these kinds of animations. So when I click on it, it slowly fades away and then disappears entirely. There's a whole set of animations that are built into jQuery that allow you to do that with a page, which are a lot of fun to play with and can be very functional in terms of adding to the experience of the user.